As Kabul was being taken over by the Taliban, there was a lot of news that was really striking that also left us with some questions. So the fact that the former president of Afghanistan, I guess still current president, Ashraf Ghani, had fled the country, that certainly raised a lot of eyebrows. But there's new details to it that, you know, grain of salt, but make it even more dramatic. Russia's embassy in Kabul said on Monday that Ghani had fled the country with 4 cars and a helicopter full of cash and had to leave some money behind as it would not all fit in. Saying, this is a spokesman for the Russian embassy in Kabul said, as for the collapse of the outgoing regime, it is most eloquently characterized by the way Ghani fled Afghanistan. 4 cars were full of money. They tried to stuff another part of the money into a helicopter, but not all of it fit. And some of the money was left lying on the tarmac. So, JR, that is obviously a horrible image. It doesn't seem, it like fits with our idea of how this sort of thing works. I would not consider it confirmed at this point. I don't know, is that being overly cautious? What do you think?
Oh, to not be sure that that's the way this went down?
Well, to not believe that necessarily this one ambassador is being 100% accurate about it. I don't rule it out at all. The corruption has been very clear for many years, but what do you think about it? How likely do you think that
is? It's definitely like believable. I mean, look, if we didn't see images of people literally grabbing onto the landing gear and the sides of this huge airplane that was taken off the tarmac, we may not believe that either, because that's some cartoonish style imagery that you may see. And you'd be like, there's no way people are that desperate enough that they're gonna jump on the sides of a plane that is moving and expect to potentially live. And also they said they found some human remains stuck in one of the landing gears once they got to where they were going. And things like that just happen. So if we didn't see it, it'd be hard to believe. So seeing another cartoon image of the former president here taking off and then literally stuffing money into the helicopter as he takes off, a helicopter, and money flying everywhere. That sounds like it's straight out of Looney Tunes. But so was the previous thing, but it's dead serious. And so I can buy it, but of course, you don't have to just confirm it and say, yeah, this one guy said so therefore it happened. But it's definitely like, it's imaginable.
Yeah, it is. And details are, there's not a lot, basically. I had seen some other reporting saying he had taken $169 million, but it's not clear if they mean that that was in cash, which seems impossible, or if funds had been transferred out of the country, but then why would you take some in cash? I don't know. I'm assuming that people, including the Taliban, are gonna be looking into this as they take over all of that. Now, he did put a post up on social media back on Sunday defending his decision to leave, saying, if I had stayed, countless of my countrymen would be martyred and Kabul would face destruction. And look, I'm just gonna say this. Maybe this makes me the bad guy. I think it's totally legitimate for him to think that he would have been killed. I think he almost certainly would have been killed. I don't think him staying would have changed the outcome at all, right? Am I wrong? Like, I don't think they would have held out against the Taliban if he'd been there. So yeah. Now that is separate from, is it cool if you leave and you strip the country of its resources on your way out? That's a different question. Or if you had known it was happening, could you have gotten additional people out? Those are important additional questions. But I'm not shocked that he thought that he would die if he stayed. That seems
pretty crazy. Well, this is how corruption works. It happens in America too. I think it was Duncan Hunter back then, senior. One of those, I don't wanna disparage the hunters, but there was a Republican politician who was getting busted, headed to jail. He literally put sacks of money in garbage cans and threw them on his wife's lawn. Jenk talks about this all the time. So it's not like it's something that's exclusive to this country because the corruption is so rampant there and it's not as rampant here. It's just, you know, we cover it up well here and do it in different ways. So things like collecting as much money as possible once you're escaping and fleeing the moment, and then taking and literally stuffing as much money in your pockets as possible is not a crazy thought. It's just what happens, because like whatever I can get left, because I've stolen it already, let me try and steal it some more before they come and get me. Why not? This is the same situation. It's not like the people are getting all that money because corruption is rampant.
Yeah, exactly. And like we said, that's been known for a very long time. I mean, should have been known when we went in. The issue was, you know, that it sucks from the point of view of the people who should be getting that money and are not. But the companies that are there to dole it out with the equipment and the staff and getting the contracts, they don't care who ends up getting the money. What is it, Lockheed or Raytheon? What do they care if Ghani stole all the money? It like literally doesn't affect them. Their stock has gone up by 1,000% over the last 2 decades. It doesn't matter at all.
They're getting more money now, from us anyway.
Exactly. Now we do have an update as of earlier this morning that Ashraf Ghani had been found. He is sheltering in the UAE. I'm saying like he had been in the woods or whatever. No, we just know where he is now. That he's been in the UAE with his family. The Gulf States Foreign Ministry confirmed the news in a statement issued on Wednesday afternoon. Now, will we ever find out if money was taken, how much money was taken? I sort of doubt it. I don't know what capacity Afghanistan, whether you know the lingering elements of, like, I think the vice president is still, you know, trying to hold out in an area, or the Taliban would be legally or technologically capable of taking the money back. It would be interesting to know, but I wonder if we'll ever have an answer to that mystery.
Yeah, I doubt it. I don't expect it. And also, if the answer does come, how much are people paying attention to it? There's so many things, man. Every day there's a new cycle of what's going on here and the next step of what happened. And then the next thought of who's going to, I mean, the Taliban's trying to push some PR scheme that they're this new welcoming governing body that's going to look out for women's rights and positions and stuff. So
I know
all these things are going to continue to happen. So things like this story are going to go quickly. By like, oh yeah, sure, he stole a bunch of money. Sure, good job. See you later, bro. And we're moving on to the next. So I don't think we're ever gonna feel the full confirmation of what really happened here.
Yeah. Well, and look, I think unless the Taliban is being totally honest, which seems impossible, we're gonna have a lot of news coming out of Afghanistan over the next few weeks, months, years. It's gonna be absolutely devastating. At the end of the day, is the money thing gonna be the most significant part? Probably not for the people who are likely to be victimized and lives are about to be taken. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.